So 2020, from a personal learning point of view, followed the philosophy that Steve Jobs used to say, learn continually because there's always one more thing to learn. And I think the focus for me was all things digital, for sure. A lot of self-learning on SEO and performance marketing and, e-commerce marketing, et cetera. And at a professional level, pushing the limits happened on multiple fronts. Some of the things that come to mind is that in about 30 days of the lockdown being announced, Colgate launched a tele-dentistry service nationally, free of charge. We realized that dentists were not able to open their clinics and people had urgent dental needs that can be very severe sometimes. And we roped in some top dentists around the country, set up a tech platform where people could, do video calls, audio calls, or chats with dentists, send them pictures of and describe the problem they were facing, and get a resolution and get a prescription online, free of charge completely. And of course, not only did we launch the platform, we also made sure that people were aware of it. And we use various media touch points to help people understand how they could access this. So that was something breakthrough and new. And done at a scale and speed that we hadn't seen done before anywhere. Another thing that we did in terms of pushing the limits was on our Palmolive portfolio. Palmolive is an iconic brand that has not been very active recently, and we have started activating it. We again participated, in the need for higher levels of hygiene, and within about 45 days of the lockdown being announced, we had our hand cleansing range in market, including hand sanitizers, et cetera, on a completely new platform that said 99% germ protection, 100% love, right? Without compromising on antibacterial, there is a enormous experiential aspect that we cannot forget in personal care. That aside, at an equity and a branding level, frankly, it's been a difficult year, right? For brands to strike the right tone, be consistent with their messaging and how we've been, but yet be aware and be sensitive to, the changes that were happening. And for us, we have a brand platform where we encourage people to be positive and optimistic. In Hindi, we say, smile karo or shuru ho jao. And, as we were planning to tell stories to encourage people to be optimistic, we realized that we had to be contextually relevant. And the stories that we then put out were around the idea that 2020 and what has happened has been a massive moment of reflection and examining our lives and reassessing how we want to live. And we put out, a few stories around that idea of moving on and being positive and using the changed circumstances to make some decisions and not be worried about societal judgment, et cetera. So we pushed boundaries there. And in terms of, innovation, again, we did something that, in the Colgate world we hadn't done before, is we realized that, people, while they brush their teeth in the morning, when they leave their homes, they're eating and drinking, and bacteria are constantly building up. And we realized that on-the-go germ protection in the mouth is a massive need. You know that germs building up through the day is really the biggest cause of most oral conditions and leads to other further health conditions potentially. And we launched the Ved Shakti Mouth Protect Spray, which, in a single spray has the power of instant germ kill. It's got a great, minty soft flavor, but really, really works. And it's a small thing, fits into your pocket. And, so on multiple levels, we pushed the boundaries in 2020. And of course, at a personal level, it was another year of terrific growth. My advice to anyone looking to make a career in marketing, is to realize that there is always going to be a short-term need and a long-term need, and to find a way constantly, both personally and professionally, to balance both, right? It's easier said than done. creating a brand is a long-term journey. It does not happen overnight, though it can get derailed overnight. Brands are a consequence of the memory structures that we are able to build in our target audiences. And building memory structures requires an enormous amount of consistent, conscious effort towards an articulated end goal or an end state. So that is the long term of it. Creating brands is difficult, and it requires persistent creativity. At the same time, the short term is where you maximize opportunities, right? And so they are the sort of exits on the highway that you got to keep taking. And for 2021 and for the near term, to become digitally highly comfortable and see how the omnichannel experience, as digital modes of consuming media, digital modes of transacting are both, constantly changing and growing. How does the omni shopping experience, the omni consumption experience, how can you maximize it? And that will happen through constantly, building on your skill sets, but also constantly reflecting and constantly seeing how brands are best built while people's, consumptions behaviors change, but biologically in fundamentally how we form images and associations, that remains constant. So balance the short term with the long term. That's going to be sort of evergreen advice.